the stars, Charles Nelson Riley, Brett Summers, Maury Amsterdam, Loretta Swit, Richard Dawson, and Runa Lee, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Hello there. Thank you very much. Hello, Johnny Olson. Thank you. I greet you and welcome you and ask if you are prepared.
Yes.
You are prepared.
Over already.
You did your homework? Yes. Okay. And let's have a brisk round of applause for our current champ, Mr. Tom Garnello. Yay. Hello, Tom.
Hi.
Last time we met, Tom had just finished winning a game, and he's going to have a go at the super match. Are you set for that?
Yes, sir. Let's go.
You got $1,300 so far, and you've just won your third game, and we'll see that to its logical conclusion. Right after this.
We're not just saying that.
No. Okay, Tom Garnello, you ready for another go here?
Yes, I am.
You know how this goes. You've been here several times. A super match. You can win a great deal of money here. You've got $1,300. Let's see how much more you're going to win. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Play blank. Or play blank. The answer given most often by that studio audience is worth $500 to you if you can match it. The second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Now, you can solicit answers here from three celebrities. Do it one at a time. See what you come up with.
All right, Charles, let's give it a go.
Okay, play ball!
Play ball, he said.
That was acting.
All right. That was acting.
I think it was acting.
Yes. You're so masculine. Okay, there's one, play ball. And how about another one?
Brett, what do you think?
I have play boy.
Play boy.
Oh.
Ho, ho.
All right, you need one more.
Richard?
Playground.
Playground. So you got play ball, play boy, and playground. You can choose one of those. Or give us one of your own right now, Tom. We need your answer.
Well, I'm a school teacher, but even though I am, I'm not going to go with that last one. I'm going to try play ball.
Play ball! The traditional umpire's cry. Play ball. The one that Charles Nelson Riley gave you. All right, that's what we're looking for. May we see the $100 response? Playground is there. That's one that Richard Dawson gave you. All right, still looking for play ball. May we see the $250 response? Play ball it is. You've got it. Okay. Now, just before we go on here, I know you're curious to see what's under the... What do you think it is?
Oh, well, must be Playboy, because those all...
You think it's Playboy? Let's reveal it right now. Playboy, you're right.
Tom, you did it again.
Yeah, Brett, you did it again. Okay. Well, you've won the $250, Tom. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. To do that, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It must be an exact match. So let's choose a celebrity now.
Brett, let's go.
Brett, just take a deep breath.
Charles.
No, you could do it.
No, he's chosen you, Brett. You get ready to write. You all set up there? All right.
Yes,
Tom, you face me. Here is the question worth $2,500. Write down your answer to this, Brett. Blank eggs. Or blank eggs. Blank eggs. Or blank eggs. E-G-G-S.
Oh, criminy Dutch.
All right. She's written her answer now. Tom, we ask for yours. How do you fill in that blank? Blank eggs.
Fried eggs.
He says fried eggs. All right, Brett, for $2,500, may we see your response?
I said raw.
Raw.
Why didn't I say fried?
What did you just say, Tom?
Well, I've been up here three times, and I haven't gotten a head-on-head yet.
Yeah, well, you're trying, and you're coming up with some good answers, and you're up to $1,550. You're still a champ, and here comes another player.
all say hello to Linda Olson. Hi, Linda.
Hi.
You know Tom Garnella, Linda? Okay. You're a very pretty lady. Are you ready to have a go at this?
Yes, I am.
Want to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, I'm a UCLA graduate. I'm an elementary school teacher, married to a high school teacher, and we have an 8-month baby boy.
Well, good luck to you. You know that you and Tom will be answering questions, trying to match our 6 celebrities. You'll have 2 chances at the end of the second round. Whoever has done that most often wins, gets $100, and the right to go to the Super Match, where you can win $5,000 or more. You may make a selection, if you would, please, Linda.
I'll take B.
She wants B. We've got a brand new game here. Everyone participates, and this is your first assignment. Fred had an American flag on his blank. Do something with that. I know I have beautiful eyes, but just write your answer there. Okay. Fred had an American flag on his blank. All the celebrities are ready, Linda. Have you thought about this?
Yes.
Where did Fred have an American flag?
Chest.
On his chest. Okay, let's see if she scores with that. Charles?
Oh, I had him out on the car. That's where I thought he would.
Really? An American flag on his car?
Yes.
Yes. Would you leave the room, please? Brett, what do you say?
Well,
she's
after
looking for a chest.
I goofed so badly with Tom after I'd been such a smart you-know-what.
Yes.
I put chest.
Chest it is. So, when do you score once? Maury?
I also said chest.
Good. That's 2 for you, Linda.
On his stomach, he had a Chinese flag, and on his abdomen, he had a Norwegian flag, and we let the rest of the world go by.
Okay. From the song of the same name. So you've scored twice up in that tier, Linda. Let's see how we do down here.
And a little one on his thigh.
On his thigh?
So with a tattoo.
Right here?
Yes.
Like this?
Yes.
Okay. Richard, what do you say?
Yes. He had an American flag on his jeans.
On his jeans.
And Jean had one on her... I think certainly right in this place, isn't it?
Rudy Lee.
Well, would you consider this a chest of a different sort, like a hope chest, a coffin?
No. So you've matched 2 celebrities,
Rudy, Linda. What happened to you?
Tom does with this. Everyone plays. Mary said to John, "Your waterbed makes me blank." Mary said to John, "Your waterbed makes me blank." Okay. What did Mary say to John, Tom?
The waterbed made him seasick.
Now, wait a minute. Okay. Oh, all right, seasick. It was Mary to John.
Okay, Mary, I still go with seasick.
Still, they're both
they're
seasick.
All, yeah.
Yeah, everybody's, the whole world is sick.
Yeah.
I'm, what the heck are you gonna do? Okay, he says seasick. Charles?
Ta-da!
Seasick. There's one, Brett.
Should I tell you about the night Jack Klugman and I spent an hour in a waterbed?
No.
He got seasick.
He got seasick. Score is tied, 2-2. Maury?
I also said seasick because we have one at home.
Oh, really?
My wife woke me the other night. She says either our waterbed is leaking or you have a problem.
So it's 3-2 in favor of our champion, Loretta?
Yes, why should I be different?
There's
seasick.
Another one. Okay, you're up to 4. Richard.
Well, actually, the waterbeds make me queasy.
We didn't. All right,
look, no folks, that's how they affect me. Now, don't get hostile. I didn't invent the thing, did I? I get on there and I'm queasy.
What do you say?
Seasick
it is. So you're up to 5, Tom.
Oh, boy.
5-2 the score in favor of our current champion. We'll go to 2, but first we've got this for you. Score here is 5-2 at the end of the first round in favor of our current champion. We'll go to 2. I remind you, Linda, that you must match 3 celebrities to stay in the running. And would you make a selection, please?
I'll go with B again.
B again?
Yes.
All right, she says hopefully. Now, last time around, you matched 2 of our celebrities, Brett and Maury. Now you'll be trying to match the others. Frank said to Doris, "This is the first time I've ever seen you blank." Frank said to Doris, "This is the first time I've ever seen you blank." celebrities down here ready, and Charles is ready. So, Linda, Frank said to Doris, this is the first time I've ever seen you blank.
Naked.
Naked. We're going to send for another group here. Just keep your clothes on, and we'll go on with the game there. All right, audience? Okay, no, Charles.
I just like to say I'm Swedish, and we have Olsons in our family, and we don't have anything that looks like Linda.
No, she's a very pretty
she's
lady.
She's beautiful.
Yes, a very
And
beautiful
I didn't
lady.
Agree with her. I didn't put naked. I put nude.
Oh, nude and naked is a match. Same thing. That scores. Okay. Now, let's come down here to Loretta.
Yes, well, I don't agree with her either. I put nude.
Nude it is. All right, you need one more to stay in the game, and you've got Richard and Ruta.
Well, the young lady was not really very attractive, and so naturally he said no nudes is good news.
Score is tied, Linda. Let's see if you match Ruta.
I do agree with Linda. Naked.
So, you got them all. You've matched all six celebrities, and now, Tom, as we go to your half of the round, you must match one celebrity to achieve a tie, and then we'll see what happens after that. Are you ready? Last time around, you matched everybody, but...
Except Captain Queasy here.
Over there. So now you'll be trying to match him. Are you ready, Captain?
Certainly.
Snow White said, with seven dwarfs living in my house, boy, is my blank crowded. Snow White said, with seven dwarfs living in my house, boy, is my blank crowded. Must match. Richard Dawson, who has finished writing, and Tom, now it's up to you.
Bedroom.
Bedroom. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's his answer. Richard, you must match Richard.
Actually, Snow White was just a little more promiscuous than you thought. Bed.
Bed and bedroom do not match. Yeah. The judge says so. The winner is Linda Olson. Come on down, Linda. Right here, if you would, please. Okay, you've got the $100 for winning the game, and now we've got to say goodbye to Tom. He's won $1,550 in his three games. Thank you, Tom, for being with us at Match Game 73. Congratulations. Thank you. Okay, so here you are. You stand at the threshold of a great deal of money here in the super match, Linda. You know how it goes. You're going to have... We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Spare blank, or spare blank. Now, the answer given most often by that audience is worth $500 if you can match it. The second most frequent, $250, and the third, $100. And three celebrities are allowed to help you out here. So would you choose them one at a time, please, and get their responses?
Charles Nelson Reilly.
Charles, how do you fill in that blank? Spare?
Ribiza.
Ribiza, he says.
Ribiza.
Spare ribiza. Okay, ribs. Got that? All right, another one?
Loretta Swit.
Spare tire.
Spare tire. Okay. Let's all suck it in now. And get rid of those spare tires. One more.
Richard Dawson.
What do you say, Richard?
Spare change.
Spare change.
Spare I said it first.
You certainly did.
Okay. So, Linda, you have spare ribs, spare
what
tire,
do you mean
and
by that?
Spare change. You think about it for a second. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own if you wish. What would you like to do?
I'll go with spare ribs.
Spare ribs. All right. That's it. That's the one Charles gave you. We're looking for spare ribs. May we see the $100 response? Spare time. That didn't show up at all, did it? Okay. Spare ribs is Linda's choice. May we see the $250 response? Spare ribs, you've got it. Congratulations.
It's spare time.
Well done, Charles. Now, Linda, you've got the $250 in the audience match. It means you play for 10 times that amount now, or $2,500. But to do that, to collect that amount of money, you must match... I forgot to reveal. I guess we're all anxious to know what's under the $500 thing. It might even be Loretta's answer, spare tire. May we see the $500 response, please? Spare tire it is. That was your answer.
Did okay. I win?
No. But she's going for $2,500 now.
And to collect it, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Whom do you choose?
I'll go with Charles Nelson Reilly.
All right.
We're practically related. We're both Swedish.
And you face me, Linda, if you would. I'll get the question. All right. That's good right about there. Now, this must be an exact match between the two of you. And get ready to write your answer, Richard. It's sewing.
I shouldn't write it because she asked Charles.
Oh, Charles.
You'll get very suspicious if you do that.
Don't turn on one another. It works better. Now I got to get up nervous all over again. All right,
you were chosen, Charles. Sewing blank. That's S-E-W-I-N-G blank. Gonna write it down there? All right. He's thinking about it. S-E-W-I-N-G blank.
Watch it.
Okay, now he's finished. Now, Linda, we call for your response. How do you fill in that blank? Sewing?
Machine.
Sewing machine. Seems to be a popular answer as far as the audience is concerned. Charles, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
I was going to write something else, but since we're both Swedish, I thought I'd write that.
Sewing machine! Okay. We'll, you've got it. Congratulations. We'll get back to you, and you're going to meet another challenger right after we hear these words of wisdom. Now it's time to say hello to a new challenger. Here is Roseanne Covey. Hello, Roseanne.
Hi.
Hello, Linda. Would you like to give us a story of your life in 28 words or less?
Time's up.
I was born in Detroit. I came to California at 7 months, and I've lived in Southern California leading an uneventful life for 21 years.
Until today.
Until today. Yes,
today may change your life.
I'm very nervous and excited.
Are you really?
Yes.
Okay, well, take a deep breath. Take another one. See how relaxed you are now?
And now I'll pass out.
Here we go. We go to round one. You know that you and Linda will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. The one who does that most often at the end of the second round will win the $100 and an opportunity to go for the super match where you can win over $5,000.
Yeah.
All right. Would you make a selection, please, A or B?
A.
You know, we ask you to make the selection because some contestants find some questions harder than others. That's why it's your choice completely. Stephanie's blank was crooked. That's your assignment. Stephanie's blank was crooked.
I heard you the first time.
I still didn't.
Okay.
Stephanie's blank was crooked.
Oh, that's easy.
Okay, they're all finished, Roseanne. So we ask you how you fill in that blank. Stephanie's blank was crooked.
Hairpiece.
Stephanie's hairpiece was crooked. Her answer is hairpiece. Charles, what's
As I said earlier in the week, I do not relate to teeth or hairpiece questions.
Right.
And because I'm now a sewing machine expert, her seam was crooked.
Her seam was crooked. Okay.
And aren't I silly?
Yes. But delightful.
Yes.
Brett, how did you handle this? Hairpiece.
Yeah, I hope she didn't get that idea from looking at me about the hairpiece. I said spine.
Her spine was crooked.
Yes. Ow.
Okay. Maury, what did you say?
I understand Stephanie was a boozer, so her corkscrew was
crooked. You really drew a blank on that one, didn't you? Okay, Loretta.
I don't think Charles is silly at all. I think her stocking seams were crooked.
Her seams.
Yeah.
Stocking seams were crooked. Okay.
I happen to know she was in show business, and her agent was crooked, but so was her nose.
Don't let it happen just yet, Roseanne. And Ruda.
I have a very dear girlfriend named Stephanie who had her nose done, so there it is.
There it is. Okay. So you didn't score with that, Roseanne. We'll get to Linda's half of round one here, but first we've got to do this for you. Time is up for this time. We'll look forward to seeing you pretty ladies next time, and we'll finish round one with your assignment, Linda. Okay, ladies?
Now, we thank you. You were all very splendid today. Yes, I'd like to just get one pearl of wisdom from Mr. Dawson before we leave. What would you like to lay on us?
Well, just remember that during, you know, these troubled times, if you can walk with your head above the crowd, you'll be taller than anyone else.
Yes, isn't that beautiful? Let's all remember that.
Andrew Van Oker.
Gene Edwards saying so long for Max King, 73.
Today's consolation prizes are a timely gift from Westflock, 17-jewel Roman Sport Ladies Wristwatch, and Boston Gold Color High Fashion from Westflock's Italian Industries Company. And a supply of Adolph's Meat Marinade works in just 15 minutes to give meat deep down gourmet flavor and juicy tenderness. Adolph's 15-minute Meat Marinade. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Secret Storm next over most of these CBS stations.